Welcome back, everyone. Today we will be discussing the Jordan 1 Seafoam. Specifically, we will be discussing some release info, how to cop, and of course, some resale predictions at the end of the video. The Jordan 1 Seafoam releases on August 12th. Retail is $170 for women's, $80 for preschool, and $60 for toddler. Stock between all sizes combined worldwide is just over 110,000 pairs. This is just about the average stock that we see for Jordan 1 highs, around 10,000 pairs of which should be going out via exclusive access prior to the drop. Now, regarding resale, we will cover that towards the end of the video, as always. With the release info out of the way, though, let us jump into how to cop these Jordan 1 Seafoams. Specifically for this how to cop, we'll be going in chronological order, along with exactly how to efficiently manage your time and set up for this drop, since a lot is going to be going on at once. Prior to discussing the first-come, first-serve online drops, though, make sure to follow my Twitter, KeithAdam10, and personals for you for any urgent updates on these, such as exclusive access. So again, make sure you are following there, not just for these, but for other urgent updates as well, such as all the Yeezy updates that I've been giving out during Yeezy Day. Also, as promised, I was also going to keep you guys updated with the progress of Gargantua AIO. In addition to already proving our dominance on foot sites with or without Kiwit, users are now starting to test out some of the collectible and retail modules too, with more coming soon. Follow the Twitter for updates and free beta key drops, which will be very soon. Also, make sure that you don't forget to sign up for the Flex app reservations. This is one of the best ways to get pairs, as well as asking local foot stores about their procedure for leftover pairs, since everyone does have their own individual procedure. Now, moving on to the online first-come, first-served sites, we'll start with the US sites in chronological order, then we'll be moving to Europe sites after. At 8 a.m. Eastern Time, we should be seeing Undefeated drop as usual. Before this time, make sure you are logged into your Undefeated account, as it is required on this site to check out. Be ready to solve a checkpoint capture as well. If you don't have access to a Shopify monitor, you could try refreshing the search page for AJ1 High, but your chances of copying will be very slim since it is Shopify. Now, moving on to the confirmed 10 a.m. Eastern Time drops, this is where the actual fun begins as usual. Since there is a lot to focus on, I'm going to guide you and suggest to you how to efficiently manage your time as usual. First, I would suggest going for Hibbett as your first come first serve choice at exactly 10 a.m. Eastern Time, since Hibbett will sell out quickly while also giving you a decent chance at manually copying compared to some of the other options we have. For everyone who was asking about the press and hold loop that you get when you try on Hibbett, this is unfortunately the result of the Perimeter X bot protection. I briefly touched on this in a prior How to Cop guide. Essentially, in order to avoid the loop, rather than refreshing the product page, visit the Coming Soon page under the Launches tab and click the product just several seconds before 10 a.m. Eastern Time. By the time it loads, you should be able to solve the first press and hold, and sizes should then show rather than continuing the loop, as it should be live. Another tip from one of the last drops: after you solve the press and hold, it's going to be very tempting to scroll down very quickly in order to select a size. However, I noticed that if you scroll very slowly, there is a significantly lower chance of getting that press and hold loop, so my suggestion would have to be to take your time when scrolling down. What is also really important is that you try to generate some activity on the website at least 20 minutes beforehand. Your goal is essentially to emulate normal customer human behavior. My biggest advice when going for Hibbett is to use Apple Pay on your mobile device for the most efficient checkout. Or, as an alternative to Hibbett, you can choose one or two Shopify sites to focus on at exactly 10 a.m. Eastern Time as your first come first serve of choice, since those will also be selling out the quickest. If I had to choose two for you guys, normally I'd go ahead and say Shop Nice Kicks and Shoe Palace, since they get pretty high stock and they do have a checkpoint captcha. However, I would not recommend it when it comes to this sneaker in particular, similar to the last Jordan 1 video, just because the margin on these certainly isn't going to be amazing, and Shop Nice Kicks and Shoe Palace are notorious for charging very, very high amounts for shipping, around $27 usually. So instead, if you prefer not to go for Hibbett still, I'd suggest trying for Jimmy Jazz and DTLR, where the shipping costs are much lower, since they do get high stock and they also do have a checkpoint too. Also, Jimmy Jazz has started loading early links, as you have seen from my recent tweeted site list, so you can feel free to try on there too, and you should be able to use the trick I was talking about in the past videos regarding the early add to cart. You could also consider going for Kith, since it does seem that Shopify has patched that hCAPTCHA exploit. In conclusion though, your 10 a.m. focus should be on Hibbett. Or if you can multitask with desktop, maybe try DTLR and Jimmy Jazz 2. I still prefer Hibbett though, personally, especially because of the free shipping, which is an important factor for this drop in particular. Now, right after those first come first serve drops are over, or even while you're waiting in the Shopify queue hypothetically, I want you guys to enter in as many sneakers accounts into the drop as possible until around 10:10 a.m. Eastern Time. This is going to be your number one chance by far for copying these, but now, what is the most efficient way to cop off of Nike sneakers? These are currently loaded as a Dan drop, which they have been doing much more frequently as of recently. Dan drops are also known as draws. You essentially have 10 minutes to enter in as many of your accounts into the raffle as possible. Evidently, the more you can enter into the period, the better your chances will be. It's the law of probability. I actually made a full in-depth video on this, which I'd highly suggest watching because there is more to it. If you need to make more accounts though, remember that Nike does require SMS verification and you can't use the same phone number twice, so you will have to ask a friend of yours to use their phone number and ask them for the verification code. However, if you rather not bother your friends or you just want a significant amount of pre-verified Nike sneakers accounts in general, feel free to check out my site TARS. The link is in the description below for pre-verified Nike sneakers and Adidas accounts. After sneakers, it'll be 10:10 a.m. Eastern Time. At this point, you'll want to shift your focus to foot sites and periodically checking Finish Line, JD Sports, and Snipes, assuming they do eventually load, to see if you have passed queue. As of now, Snipes did not have them loaded on their calendar, but I do expect them to load closer to the drop. Make sure to set up the tabs for these sites beforehand. You should be setting them up as soon as my account or Personals for You tweets out the links. This way, you're already ready to go and waiting in queue after Nike sneakers. The key to copying on foot sites, which is Foot Locker, Kids Foot Locker, Foot Action, East Bay, and Champs, is persistency, not exactly speed. However, as of 2021, manual has changed from very difficult to nearly impossible ever since Datadome was introduced to foot sites, replacing Akamai. Regardless, it's worth trying out this time anyway, since there isn't much else going on after sneakers anyway. As for Finish Line, JD Sports, and Snipes, if they do load, of course, as you're trying to cart on foot sites, just periodically keep checking your tabs to see if you have passed queue yet. When you do pass queue, it's pretty self-explanatory from there. Just try to add the cart and check out. That will conclude it for the US sites though. Now moving on to Europe. Although many Europe retailers are doing raffles, there are still some first come first serve drops to prepare for. Just keep in mind that retail is slightly higher for Europe, which leaves very little room to profit, unfortunately, which we'll discuss later. Best drop for Europe would of course have to be Nike sneakers at 9 a.m. CEST. They are loaded as a Dan drop, also known as a draw, which we did discuss earlier. Since this is a draw, you won't need to prioritize this site at exactly 9 a.m. CEST. Instead, I'd suggest focusing on another first come first serve of your choice, then coming back to sneakers right afterwards. It is extremely likely that Soulbox and Snipes will both be dropping at 9 a.m. CEST or slightly later as usual. If you have access to a Soulbox and Snipes monitor, you will have a decent chance of copying from there. If not, I would suggest following more sneakers or Personals for You on Twitter. I would also suggest making accounts beforehand and being signed in. Similar to Hibbett, you should also try generating some activity on the site beforehand to reduce the Perimeter X capture loops. The same goes for both sites. Zalando and Courier should also both be dropping, but they have not loaded the products just yet. Then Offspring could potentially drop too. For Offspring, I would suggest enabling post notifications on their Instagram if you don't have access to a monitor. They're relatively fast at sending it out when it does go live. They normally don't drop at 9 a.m. whenever they do though, so no need to focus on there at exactly 9 a.m. Foot Locker will also drop as well. Try to use multiple Chrome users to pass queue here. Foot Locker will probably be the worst drop as usual. Just leave tabs open and see if you do pass queue. And again, since Foot Locker is a queue release, you do not need to focus there at exactly 9 a.m. CEST. But that will be it for the how to cop portion of the video. Now with the how to cop out of the way, let us move on to the resale predictions. As mentioned earlier, the current stock on these is around the same level of stock that we typically see from Jordan 1 highs, so nothing unusual here. Now, although pre-sale is high at the moment, it is important to keep in mind that we are over a week out from the drop. For being 1 week out, this certainly is not the ideal situation, especially considering exclusive access has not even gone out for these yet. The bids certainly do not stand out much either, unfortunately, especially for this being far out from the drop. Overall, I am expecting lunch money for these with a subpar margin, and a decent margin in size of 10 and up, the bigger the better. I'm expecting just a slightly better performance than the Jordan 1 Electro Orange, but nothing significantly more. Overall, I will be going for these, expecting only about lunch money. And when it comes to these lunch money drops, I really try to emphasize to you guys that these are really fantastic because this small amount of lunch money per pair really does tend to add up. And it's much easier to cop a pair like this compared to one of the more extremely limited releases with much higher profits. So these releases certainly do have their place. Make sure to take advantage of them. I'll likely make a more in-depth seller hold video as well the night before the drop, so make sure to subscribe and enable post notifications for a more in-depth analysis. As of right now, being over a week out from the drop, this is more or less just a vague estimate as usual. Anyway, that will conclude it for today. Feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed, or perhaps if you learned a thing or two, subscribe and enable post notifications just to stay 100% updated on all hyped releases. Also, feel free to check out the links in the description below for reliable, fast, residential proxies and pre-verified Nike sneakers or Adidas accounts. Also, feel free to follow Endurance's Twitter for updates on restocks or key giveaways, and the same goes for Gargantua if you want to keep up with the progress or free beta key drops. Last but not least, make sure to follow KeithAdam10 and Personals for You so you guys stay updated on all the urgent info like I was discussing today. With that though, I will see you guys later. Have a fantastic rest of your day and good luck. Away from me, get your foot on my foot.